For having us on the program, yes, you're right. The Zulu term for the Drakensberg is uKhahlamba, which means the barrier of spears. And you asked me earlier about these mountains, and they pushed out about 400 million years ago. This landmass came through, and that was during the Ice Age. And believe it or not, where you're standing now, one day what used to be a seashore. So the ocean was here, and the mountains pushed up through the oceans.
But it was also a battlefield. Give us background into that.
Now, there have been many battles fought here. And there's the Langabaleli Pass in our area. But I think most importantly, there's a mountain known as the Spierenkop Mountain. And the battle on Spierenkop goes down as probably the most futile and bloodiest battle ever fought on African soil. And arguably, it's the one that most people know about. If you go abroad, you will find that most people you speak to know about the Spierenkop Mountain. And it has a really big link, which lots of people have lost sight of from a touristic point of view. And that is the one end of the Liverpool football ground at Anfield is known as the Kop End, and that has been abbreviated from Spierenkop, and it's in memory of the men who lost their lives in the Battle of Spierenkop. And so it's rather interesting to find how many people are now coming to these battlefields and how the numbers of visitors are growing. You know, there was a time when the Anglo-Zulu Wars, St. Luana and Rorke's Drift, used to get about 22,000 guests a year. We now find that we are starting narrowing the gap on that. When we first started, Spierenkop was getting around 4,000 visitors. We've now got up to 18,000 visitors. So tourism onto the battlefields of KwaZulu-Natal is big. And, you know, the more we market it, the greater the chances that we'll get more people coming.
How much of the history plays a role in drawing people to these parts of KZN?
Well, you know, at the end of the day, the wars that were fought here were mainly brought on by the British. And it is actually British history on African soil. And so it's the British people who come in large numbers to visit the battlefields and to find out more about what happened in the various battles.
And put the two and two together, especially those that from Liverpool.
Well, yeah, those were the people from the north. They fought for the Royal Lancashires, the Lancashire Fusiliers, the South Lancashires. They all fought at the Battle of Spierenkop. And so that in itself brings people to visit this part of the world.
Why is it so important for us to know our history?
You know, I take many people out to talk to them about South African history, and I'm absolutely convinced that it is not possible to go into the future without first looking at the past. And the great tragedy for us in South Africa is that the majority people have never been afforded the benefit of an education, so they don't know about our past. And it's vital that we know about our past in order to go into the future. And I spend a lot of my time talking to people about education. We have to educate the majority people, and we have to do that as a matter of urgency.
All right, Raymond, thank you so much for talking to us. Raymond Heron is the local historian, giving us a bit of history about the Drakensberg as well as the area that we're in, uKhahlamba, which of course means barriers of spears. And that's, of course, where we are broadcasting from until 9 o'clock this morning. This is the area where the KwaZulu-Natal Department of Tourism and Economic Development is launching is KZN is summer campaign. And let's take an app break. We're back after this. We'll talk to a couple more people regarding this campaign as we head to 9 o'clock. Stay with us.